I'm Christine from First Updates Now. We're here with Shaker Robotics. They're from Latham, New York, and they just came off of an awesome win at the Tech Valley Regional last weekend. And here we have two awesome students. We're going to talk a little bit about what's making their robots so awesome. So, Ben, do you want to tell us a little bit about your awesome intake?
So one of my favorite things about this robot is the intake. So a lot of teams this year had horizontal intakes for their hatches, but ours is vertical. And these little whiskers here bend a fair bit, meaning we can come into up to a 30-degree angle. Another thing is this intake here. A lot of teams went for a centering intake that just sucks the ball in and pushes it to the center, but we went for an intake that can just touch and go. Like, we can get the ball about here and it'll still intake it. It's just meant to grab it and go.
That's pretty awesome. So how many different, like, prototypes or variations did you go through before landing on this awesome
this
design?
This is our third iteration of this, of the ball intake. We had a centering intake to initially begin with. Then we had one that had a slightly lower compression, and now this is the final version that just whoop.
Well, it seems to be working out really well for you. And we're going to have somebody talk to us about their awesome line tracking that's going on down on this side of the robot.
So. Yeah, awesome. So this is our line following mechanism that we have here on the front of our robot. So inside of this 2x1 aluminum piece, we actually have four IR sensors that are facing downwards towards the field. And each one can pick up on the difference between the carpet and the white gaffer tape on the floor. And so then each of those sensors goes up to this custom PCB, which then goes back to our Rio. And we're able to pick up when the line is underneath which sensor, and so our line following code drives us forward and centers us on the line. And so we're using this as opposed to vision because it's proved to be really reliable for us as the line's right underneath our robot. And then we also have this LED strip up here which indicates to our driver when we've crossed on top of the line, and then he knows that he can use the line following command to line us up on the rocket or the cargo ship.
That's pretty amazing. So we have a lot of teams using Limelight this year, but this seems to be working out really, really well for them. So you guys are currently undefeated right now at the Central New York Regional, right? That's pretty amazing. Congratulations. So how many more matches do you guys have left, and what are those matches looking like?
Two today and then three tomorrow. We have a couple tough matches, and then I think our last two matches are somewhat manageable. None of them are too bad. The last two matches today, I have a one-match turnaround. That's our third set of one-match turnarounds today.
Wow. So that's pretty crazy. It seems like you guys are really dialed in at this event. I'm excited to see what else this robot is going to bring to the field. Congratulations on your past win and qualifying for the Detroit World Championships. That's going to wrap it up for this Behind the Bumpers segment. So thank you to 2791, and good luck to them for the rest of the season.
Thank you very much.